old and dark and reeking of death. We remembers an ancient battle fought here between the forces of good and the dark armies of Zarak. Now the marshes are full of the restless dead.
Greetings, stranger. I am the boatman. It is I who ferry lost souls on their final journey to the land of the dead. But hold, have we not met before? Sir Daniel Fortescue! Not you too. Thanks to Zarok's meddling them up to me eye sockets and lost souls have woken from the eternal sleep. Business hasn't been this brisk since before they invented sanitation. Look, if you help me to gather up a boatload of 8 lost souls and bring them here, I'll drop you off at the sunken town of Melamine. How's that sound?
Yeah.
Gracious of you. Makes a change to meet a polite young skeleton after dealing with those filthy zombie types. Up aboard.
Danielle, I've got something here I can give you, but I've no idea what it is. Do you fancy a little gamble, Mike?
Look at you. It must be 500 years since you were last on my ferry. You don't look a day over 400. Now, here we are. Xarok's magic has caused the lost mythical town of Melamede to rise from its watery grave. See you soon.
The ancient people of this long-vanished town once sought to harness the power of crystals found in the caverns below. Now, Zarak seeks to unlock the secrets of this arcane science. This mine shaft leads deep into the earth to certain doom in the crystal caverns.
Come on. All right, Dan, man. How you doing? Now then, have you got yourself a magic sword? What? Daniel, man, you can't go into battle against an army of undead without a magic sword. Here, take mine. You'll never have to sharpen another blade, or my name's not Dirk Steadfast. It's not enough just to have a magic shield, you know, no matter what that soft, ticky stern card says. Good lad. Why, I'd sooner go into battle holding a tea tray than carry that weedy Gale's shield of his.